This demo will show how to add an equals method to the person class that we're currently building up. The person class that is shown here is the working version of this phase 6 that we left off with last time. So we'll open up person as our working version and scroll down to where we've left a placeholder for an equivalence method and start working. Now I'm going to try to comment and annotate this so that it looks like the lecture materials, but if I don't get it quite right, don't worry, all the right changes will be in the saved PersonPhase7.java file. For starters, remember that we said that an equals method is pretty standard across Java classes. So this is the standard interface for equals. And we're going to start out with that interface. It's public. Returns a boolean, the name is equals, and it takes one input argument, the generic object type obj. And all this is saying is that this equals method, I need an s there, will accept an input object of any type. So just to frame this, let's open and close those brackets, braces rather. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to check and see that we're comparing apples to apples. So we're going to check whether objects are of the same type. And the way we do that is with the instance of method. So I'm going to frame this code by doing an if, and I'll leave those parentheses empty for now, open, close, and I will follow that with the companion else clause. I like to just frame my code in this way, match up braces early so that I don't have to hunt them down later. But for now, the first thing we want to do is check whether obj is an instance of, an instance of is one word, person. So we're checking whether this input object obj is of type person. And if it's not, we know that we're performing an apples to oranges comparison, and we can just stop right here because we don't need to check any further. We know that the result is false, so we can simply return that right away. If this object is of the person type, we know we're comparing apples to apples, and we can continue on. So the first thing we'll want to do is to typecast into the intended object type. And what we will do is we will say person P equals, and here's the casting, person in parentheses obj. So we've determined that this object is a person, it's one of us, so we're going to turn it from this generic object type into a more specific person type. And from this point forward, this person object P is going to represent the object obj that was passed into this method. Once we get to this point, we're going to check on a field by field basis whether all the fields of the current person are equal to the fields of this person, or rather this person right here. So now we're going to check field by field on all fields. And I'm going to frame this again with an if, open brace, closing brace, companion else, open brace, closing brace. Again, I like to do this to make sure everything is matched up early on. So this is the check that we're going to be doing. And right now, we've only got the one instance variable to work with, this string first name. So that is going to form our check. And what we'll do is we'll compare the first name, p.getFirstName is the first name field of our input object. And this entire expression returns a string. And because that's a string, we need to use equals to make a comparison. So we're simply going to apply the equals method to it. And what are we going to compare it to? We're going to compare it to our instance variable first name, or more properly, more specifically, this dot first name. Now notice here, I don't necessarily have to use get first name because this is the current object I'm dealing with, and I have direct access to that instance variable. If you wanted to, you could turn this into get first name, 601, half a dozen or the other, for all I care. But the point is, we've got one instance variable and we're checking it. And if these are the same, so far our object is the same, so we'll return a true. And if that's not the case, if as so much as one of the instance variables differs, this is why I like to post things ahead of time, we're going to return a false. Now let me look at this. I don't think this is quite right. Let's do an extra parenthesis there and a little space there. So right now we have one instance variable, so we have one check in our condition. But I think you can kind of look ahead and see that for every instance variable we add, all we need to do is add another such condition with an AND operator. And we can expand this to all the instance variables we'll eventually be implementing. But for now, we'll leave it at this. So at this point, I want to save, do a test compile. And it looks like I'm still missing one parenthesis. Ah, here it is. I think I need an extra one here. Let's save that, compile it, and now I'm good. Yeah, see, it's nice to match those up when you frame your code so that you don't have to find it later. So that's all that a typical equals method looks like. So now that we have this built, how do we go about testing it? I'm just going to compile it one time. Yep, everything's fine. Well, as we said, when we implement some new capability, we should add it to our main method test code, and we will do the following to test it. In the lecture materials, we said that there were three tests that we should always perform. So let's put some pseudocode here. So two different objects should differ. That's one test. We should also check the same object against itself and make sure that it is by necessity equal. And also, let's test our person class against some other type of object to test the instance of logic. Okay, so there are our three tests. And the first one we'll do, I'm just going to print out the result of this, system.out.println. And in fact, I'm going to make this easy on myself. I'm just going to clone that into all three checks, like so. Then for this first one, I want to check whether P1 equals P2. And P1 and P2 are two person objects that we should already have on hand from our earlier tests with constructors. So what we'll check here is simply Person1, its equals method, and a second object of the same kind. So this is going to just print out a true or false result. In this next test, we're going to check whether P2 equals itself. And so what we'll do here is we'll do P2 dot equals P2. And this had better be true because an object must be equal to itself. Finally, in the third check, let's set up, probably shouldn't do it this way, Well, for simplicity, I'm just going to declare this here. I'm going to say temp equals a new string. I'll say junk. And I'm going to compare whether P2 equals junk. Actually, it's not junk, is it? It's temp. And what we'll do here is we'll do P2.equals. And then what we're putting in here is some object. Well, temp is a string, so it's an object. So this does represent an apples to oranges comparison, and we want to make sure that this one is false. So again, let's save this, compile it. We haven't introduced any errors, that's good. And let's run this. And let's predict what we should get. We should get a false from this first test, a true from the second test, and a false from this third test. So let's see if we get that. And this is what we get at the end. False, true, and false, exactly as we expect. I'm going to add some output code here to space that a little bit, make it a little more readable. Again, I'll save, compile, run. This is a previous check. There's the results of our equals checking. So when you're testing your equals, you should at the minimum do these three simple checks. And recognize that none of these statements depend upon the actual class or object being tested. So these three checks should suffice for pretty much any class, including the one you'll be writing. And that's about all there is to it. Finally, there's one more thing you should really do. And now that we've got some additional working changes, we should probably snapshot this off into its own file. So we'll save this as PersonPhase7.java, and we'll save anyway because it still has the class name of person inside of it. That's okay. But now we've got a saved snapshot in case anything goes haywire later. We can always fall back to this. And the file that will be posted on Canvas may differ from this one a little bit in case I haven't gotten the commenting exactly the same. You can see what it's supposed to look like if you download this and take a look at this version. Okay, well that's it on how to add an equals method to your own person class.